type of car can enter, but experience has shown that four-wheel drive vehicles are the more frequent survivors. Off-roading will almost certainly break the family saloon, but shouldn't break the bank. This is one of the cheapest of all the motorsports. It's a sort of motorcycle scrambling on four wheels, a test of both the man and the machine, usually against the clock. However, if you spend your Sundays washing and polishing your car, then forget it. There's no future in it for you if you're going to worry about scratch paintwork, lots of mud, collapsed suspension, or the odd bent wing or two. Off-roading is a cult, and off-roaders seem to have only one topic of conversation.
I started off-roading about a year ago. I joined the club with a Land Rover.
At first, I just really used it for pottering about, getting from A to B, and eventually I started kind of adding things to it. You know, I saw another one with a cow bar on the front, so I thought that'd be good. So I got one of them and eventually put wheels on, and then I started going to some... didn't have any wheels on it.
Got into Range Rovers because John bought one to tour with and to generally get around with, and I thought they were good to look at, and I never quite got off them until I actually drove one. And when you drive one for a bit, they're a habit forming thing. You can't get out of the thing, and if you can go on a road, off a road, up the side of a tree, anywhere, that's my scene, man. Who said that?
Quite frightened me to compete, because I went round with John, and it's very hairy, you know, break your wrists and things like that, literally you can. Yeah, I'll have a go, yeah, I'll try it twice, three times, four times.
I do it as much as I can when the band's not working. And so it's good fun, because when you've been having a hard tour, it's a nice release, you know, back from the playing and sweating and everything. So I'll get back into this and just get just as scared.
The night before an event is the last chance to make the vital checks that can make the difference between finishing or not. It's not a dangerous sport, but the safer the vehicle, the safer the driver.
I know this afternoon it was really pulling to the left when I was braking. I think you'll find some oil down there, Alvin, actually.
It's a bit bad.
Yep, you're right, there is. Must be a seal leaking.
Is that bad?
Well, it would be on the public road, but off-road you'll be okay.
Yeah. Well, I'll take it down the trailer tomorrow anyway.
Yeah, that's true.
Yeah, so we'll just get by for tomorrow, eh? And just...
That's right. One of these are going to be a little bit...
No. Could you just give her a pump up?
Yeah, sure.
Okay,
lovely.
Okay.
Serenaded by a blackbird that thinks the lights from the garage herald the dawn, John and Alvin complete their final checks. Tomorrow, the competition. Win or lose, John will be happy. For status quo and all the other off-road fanatics, it's the thrill of the drive that counts.